This is the largest machining plant for rotating tool holders in the world.
Actually. Really? Wow, this is a crazy place.
I do hear that there are some people that have literally worked here for decades, and they still haven't even themselves been inside parts of that area.
That's right.
We have the in-depth practical machining experience where your name comes from, right?
Quite true.
It is your own automation, making your own tools, after your own tools, made your own tools.
Yeah, you can put it like this.
There are 30 to 40 people per shift, and only one guy normally in the tool room. Just imagine how efficient it is. We have 170 CNC machines, and we have 14 presetters.
Jeez.
Because it's way too expensive in keeping the machines idle.
What's up, guys? Ian Sandusky from Lakewood Machine and Tool back here again for Practical Machinist. We have a very special episode of Making the Cut for you here today. You may remember from our earlier Making the Cut episode that we got to check out the Heimer location in North America. We are actually here in Germany, in Egenhausen, at the global headquarters of Heimer. Behind me, this is where it all started, from a little house all the way up to the location you see today, right here. So we're gonna go inside, we're gonna see how they make their tool holders, shrink fit, presetters, heat shrink, everything you can imagine is made right here at this location or one of the other locations here in this town. Let's go check this place out. So as mentioned, guys, we have a very special surprise for you today. I know we've done a tour of Heimer's North American facility, but today we are here in Germany and I'm joined by the one, the only, Andreas Heimer. Mr. Heimer, thank you very much for joining us today.
Please call me Andreas. Nice to meet you. Welcome, Practical Machinist, and we are happy to have you here in Germany, in Egenhausen, Bavaria, Germany, south of Germany. I hope you enjoy your time here.
And what are some of the things we're going to see here today?
Oh, well, today we are going to have a great in-depth tour of the Heimer facility. We are going to see a huge soft machining factory, basically. We are then going to enter into our grinding and fine precision machining, and actually get an overview about our technology and application center. So you get a very in-depth tour about where the Heimer product is actually made.
Square feet is this facility?
Wow, that's a 45,000 square feet facility here. And there are 90 CNC machines inside. So there have been new ones, old ones, everything grouped together. Ooh. Because we've split it, the fine machining, the grinding, and the soft machining, because the processes have nothing much in common.
Right.
And then here is really where the metal removal starts.
Oh, so wow. Look at this place.
We have some legacy machines there. So we see really some history of when we started 20 years ago, like these burying machines.
Oh,
with
wow.
With the big KUKA robot over there.
Oh, that one over there.
Yeah, the very big one over there. That's really one part of how we started in automation.
That thing's enormous.
The main product what we are producing here is tool holders, up to 4,000 tool holders per day.
Per day?
Per day. This is the largest machining plant for rotating tool holders in the world. Actually.
Really?
Absolutely.
Wow.
And you know, you see a combination of 5-axis machines, also some legacy machines which will replace step by step. There is some manual loading still, but you see like the new machines, you know, one robot serves one machine.
Right.
And whenever we cannot buy a plug and play solution for automation, we use our own automation in-house.
That is a 100% domestic in-house process.
We are the only maker really that has the whole solution and is really machining the own beds for presetters in-house, the tool holders, the shrink machines, the spindles of our presetters, balancing machines, you know, that really separates out the mechanical accuracy in terms compared to our competition. This is the shop floor, thousands of tools get produced here, and I think you can eat from the floor here because, you know, there's no dirt because we keep our machines and everything tidy because we found out that the guys feel much more comfortable, they're just more productive, more accurate when they work in a nice, tidy production shop.
And nobody wants to work in a dungeon.
Absolutely. So here we walk in, we see, of course, tool holders, all sorts of different material that we are machining here.
Wow.
But really what we wanted to show you is also when we walk inside here, a typical cell, we're producing different parts. Here you see the magazine.
Wow.
With 180 spots. But you know, these are four identical NHX 4000 with a 16 pallet, 180 magazine spots basically for automated production.
You guys obviously are using your own tools, your own tool holders, but you can't run them till they blow. If you were running them till they blow, you guys would still have a scrap rate that would probably, you know, have too many deviations. What do you guys have in place to try to stay on top of that?
So we work with RFID systems, and we can just check it out here. And I like to point out, for instance, you know, all the new machines come with an RFID system, but how do you know how much tool life you still have on there?
Right.
You cannot see it. You have the RFID writing on, and that's where we have these little data sheets, basically. Instead of having paper, we move into paperless, so we push on Kotek, reading Kotek, and here we have a digital data sheet. And when we see, the operator can see, I wanted to reach 100 parts, I still have 75 left, and that's my warning here with two parts. When this tool still can make two parts, there is a warning to exchange it, basically. And so it's live connected with the database, back writing on the RFID. And what we have eliminated here, you just see this little print labels, but they all have an RFID. And if they don't have an RFID, they have a QR code, because that system can also scan a QR code.
And is this something you guys developed for yourself in-house?
Absolutely.
This is one of the craziest systems I've ever seen in my life, because especially when you're doing, what you guys do here is high precision, high production machining. Trying to stay on top of that, you can have tool life timers, you can kind of have your estimates. This is the first thing I've ever seen where that is actually quantified, tracked, and I would take it that you can go and actually export data out of this.
Absolutely.
To be able to see if those tools are performing the way they should. Now this up here actually looks like a clean room.
Absolutely, it's our tool room actually. We are controlling and operating and managing over 90 CNC machines out of this room.
Can I tell you something that's really funny? This looks like not only a showroom, but it looks like the US showroom. And when you see those places, you're like, oh man, this doesn't look like a shop floor, but this is the shop floor.
This is the shop floor. This is really the secret how we can run it lean with only two guys working in the tool room for 1.5 shifts, but we are operating a 3-shift environment 6 days a week.
So these two guys, their full-time job is tool measuring, tool presetting, heat shrinking, basically supplying the whole shop with all their tooling.
Absolutely. So I want to introduce you to Matthias. Yes, please lead the way. We follow you.
Here I have the old tool and our EAC system. So here I have the ID number I put there, and then the system starts automatically the lift to run.
So it knows what shelf that's on.
Absolutely. Wow. And it tells you which layer you have to pick. So you cannot make any mistake. The red dot over there, you see it?
Oh, that's an indicator.
That's a laser.
That's crazy.
So in here, now I have the right tool.
So he's scanning the holder, and the actual machine, will actually move to the right position.
Oh, so that's for the actual heating element there.
Heating element. So you scan it, the machine knows which diameter it moves in Z, and in diameter, like the iris of a camera, actually. So you are just concentrating the induction on the right spot.
Right.
He's taking on the length of the total tool assembly, because he wants to exactly identically replace it. And that's why we are working here in a very lean environment, because he is so efficient. There is no over tightening, no under tightening,
right.
No ticking for the runout. It's always 3 micron runout on top of the cutting tool. And as it is blinking, not a time, not a light show, it's a real temperature measurement. You can feel free and safely touch it because it's below 50 degrees Celsius.
Yeah, so completely cool.
No coolant, nothing. It's very clean, very solid.
And just to clarify, these are Heimer tools inside Heimer tool holders.
Absolutely. I want to show you that every single process we're doing the balancing. So that means we are turning 1100 RPM He's doing an index measurement. And
so right now that's detecting if there's any kind of vibration in it.
Yes, and we are measuring the force dealt to the spindle to make sure that there is no unbalance or higher unbalance than allowed. We are within G2.5, G1.4 at 18,000 RPM. We are good to go.
And because that's green, that means we're gonna have less chatter, we're gonna have less run out, better accuracy, better tool life, everything you
spindle,
want.
Longer spindle lifetime.
Longer spindle life.
Yeah, I mean, so that's absolutely true. Now we are switching to the presetting sites where he's cleaning the tool. If we now move into the software, if we look at the screen, you can see he's doing an easy measurement.
So for people who don't know how this works, this is almost like a super advanced shadow graph.
He reads the chip, he presses yes, and he writes all the data on the chip, basically, because he has exchanged the cutting tool, the new tool life is programmed, and he has still his sticker. And the sticker, I told you, for the legacy machines has also a QR code on.
If you get one like this, you get a presetter and you get a balancer at the same time.
That's the multitask machine, yes.
Now that information is gonna travel with that tool throughout its lifetime in your shop.
Absolutely, that travels with it and we will enter it into machine control. So before we saw an UNO and a balancing machine, this is an automatic RFID system reading it.
And, oh!
And Matthias actually will, while the machine will start to move, fully automatic, they will start with a macro. He will actually, this machine will work alone, so fully automatic, and he will do at the same time, while the machine here is running, he will actually make the next job. Look at that. The machine has measured it. It shows we are out of tolerance. If we hit that flute, we can inspect the flute. The machine will go automatic to the right flute now. We are now on the right flute. It will automatically go to the right flute. And now in the software on the screen, if we look at the software screen, you will see, oh, now we know why it's out of tolerance.
It found that on its own.
So that's really how, and this is really how Matthias is working with his team for 90 CNC machines. There are 30 to 40 people per shift, and only one guy normally in the tool room. Just imagine how efficient it is, how much you can reduce your setup time, and how you can extend your productivity.
This is one man churning out tools for a whole factory all by yourself.
Here we are in the tool holder grinding department already, so the material, the tool holders, came back from our Motzenhoven plant. Now we are doing the grinding. So you see there is some automation cells, and in these automation cells we are automatically loading our tool holders. We are grinding some parts of the tool holders in here, and as I mentioned before, it's all done by us, fixturing by us and so on. So it's self-made.
It is your own automation, making your own tools after your own tools made your own tools.
Yeah, you can put it like this.
Now I see some pretty crazy tooling here. I see cutaways. Is this, I'm guessing this is pretty much the selection that we have on display today.
That's right. Here you see a big variety. That's part of our program. So it's from small to big. We are doing from HSK 25 to HSK 125 in the series. But here, of course, you can even see HSK 160B.
Wow. I gotta point you this way from the little stuff. What are we looking at here?
That's special holders we do for aerospace, for example. So
wow.
Very special design. This is done by our own design department, of course.
Oh, so you guys do custom stuff?
We do it, of course. You have to. So we support our customers wherever we are. We have a big variety of standard program. So in total, I think we have more than 10,000 standard articles. But of course, for our customers to support them, if they have special needs, we can't deny that. The last step of our tool holder production is the fine balancing. So we did the grinding in here, and now we're gonna see the fine balancing.
Wow.
But of course, here behind the scenes is our top secret area.
Behind
the walls. So no access for us, but behind the walls we do the grinding, and of course here we do the fine balancing on these automatic balancing. So it's our own balancing machines, automated balancing machines, 4-axis, and we are balancing and directly removing also the material by drilling.
And would you say that every tool gets some kind of
removal to it in that process. Almost every tool has to be, for every tool, it has to be removed some material.
The tools are balanced. Where are we going to go next?
Tools are balanced. And of course, the last thing, you know, quality wins, is our quality inspection. So we're going to have a look at the quality measuring room.
Perfect.
And you know, we do the double 100% inspection. So 100% is measured at the machine tool, and 100% is the second quality inspection is done by our quality inspection team.
And this is every single tool that comes
out? Every single tool.
Not randomly sampled?
No, no. 100%.
Wow, this is a crazy place.
What we are doing there is to check this taper by 1,000 points. So we are checking the taper by 1,000 points in roundness and in straightness.
Easy.
We are measuring here 83 tolerance, which means 3 microns of straightness and 3 microns maximum of roundness.
3 microns.
Maximum. So we are here now in the application center, Iren. So here we are doing demos for customers, trainings for our employees or for our partners, distributors, and so on.
I do notice this one thing behind us. I recognize this from IMTS last year.
Right, right. We showcased it at IMTS. It's the automatic automation cube, and we are doing automatic shrinking and presetting in this.
So this thing, you literally load your tools in, you're gonna get finished tools out the other side.
Absolutely. So we are preparing and shrinking, unshrinking tools, and then presetting them for the night shifts, for example.
So I see you guys have a lot of equipment in here. How many people would work in here in a normal day?
Normal 4 people, but now I'm alone.
You're here right now by yourself.
Yeah. I'm the boss guys, right here.
I see you guys have quite a few DMG Moris in here.
Yeah, a lot of cool machines.
You guys have turning, milling. Do you guys have 5-axis in here?
3 milling machines. These 2 machines are 5-axis and 1 turning machine.
And 1 turning machine.
Yeah.
And you guys have some machines that go up to some really huge footprints.
Yeah, that's right.
Like this one here.
Yeah, a really big block. We're milling here for a test for the shrinking cube.
Oh, really?
Yeah, this was.
So you're just torture testing those tools and just destroying them.
Yeah.
That's and that's right. Half the fun of it, right?
Yeah.
So there you have it, guys. That was the Heimer facility here, the headquarters in Germany where it all started. I hope you guys have enjoyed this tour. Thank you very much to the Heimer team for hosting this episode of Making the Cut. It was really cool to see not only how these tools get made, but seeing these tools make more of these tools. Really interesting stuff to see, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to find out more about Heimer, make sure you check out their website. And as always, make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on notifications below to make sure you never miss a video. You take care.